Obviously an exciting day for Justin and for our program, for that matter. The research that we were able to do indicated that Justin is going to be picked somewhere in the first round. Most of the information I got was between the 10th pick and the 20th pick. Where that turns out to be, I think, is going to be largely up to Justin over the course of the next couple months with his preparation and with some workouts as time goes on. But, you know, Justin is, as we all know in here, the amount of progress he's made in less than 2 years when he first arrived on campus is like nothing I've ever seen. You know, he took full advantage of his redshirt year and developed his body, developed his stamina. And then obviously he translated that to some pretty good play on the floor for us this season. So while I'd love to coach him some more, I certainly understand his decision and support his decision. And I think there's a lot of us, our fans included, that would like him to come back next year. I think most of the reasons for that are selfish reasons, because we want to see him play some more, we want to coach him some more, or we want him to be our teammate one more year. But I think in the long run, this will turn out to be a good decision for Justin. He certainly has thought long and hard about it. I would say 10 days ago, he was 100% certain he was going to go down this road. A week ago Sunday, I think he tapped the brakes a little and decided he wanted to think about it a little bit more. We had some in-depth meetings with his family and some agents that I think answered a lot of his questions and provided a little bit more clarity to where this is going to go from here. So I'm extremely, extremely proud of him. And obviously I'm going to turn into a huge Justin Patton fan moving forward as he makes the next step of his life, which is to the NBA. Be happy to answer questions, Justin, or I.
Justin, this is for you, I guess. Just what Mac alluded to there, what were some of those doubts in the final days leading up to it, and what were some of the questions you were maybe teetering on as far as things that might keep you in Omaha or send you there, and how were they answered for you? What did you find out?
There wasn't really any doubts. Coach Mack has surrounded me with a lot of great people. Just being at Creighton, I'm around a lot of good people and like a lot of smart people. And I was talking to a lot of people, and one thing they were all talking about was like never eliminate all your options. And this is like big business people who are really successful at what they do, and that's like something I really thought about. And if you want to go somewhere, you never want to eliminate an option, and whether it's coming back or going or whatever it is. So I talked to some people, and that was the main thing, and it was just going about it as smart as I can. I felt like that was the best option, just to tap the brakes, like Coach Mack said, and just think about everything in depth and have fun with it at least and stay in the moment. So I think I made that first decision like out of impulse, and then after thinking about it and like all the logistics and everything, I came to the right decision.
Justin, what did the NBA scouts or the people who evaluated, what did they tell you about the draft and where you would be picked, and was there a point where you said, that's not high enough, I want to come back? Explain that.
I really haven't had any really like definite contact with like NBA scouts or anything, but there's been like ranges and stuff, and we did like the research that Coach Mack alluded to, and they gave us a range, and that's never really definite. It's about how hard I'll work in that process and whatever, so it's really just going to be about how hard I work and stuff like that, where I end up.
Yeah, the NBA personnel is not allowed to talk to him, so it has to be me, or obviously the agents that we met with gave him some feedback as well.
Hey, Justin, now that this day is here, yesterday was here, what's it feel like just to have this out of the way, and how much at peace are you with this decision?
It's a huge weight lifted off my shoulders, and I feel like everyone can go home and go to sleep now, I think, because I was getting so many questions and stuff like that on social media and stuff, and the little kids and stuff, they're all just like wondering. So it's fun to have reassure everybody like what I'm doing, so they don't have to be on their toes. And I feel good personally, you know. It's not been a long time coming. I never knew I'd be in this situation. I'm blessed to be in this situation, but as I came to the decision, this feel like a weight been lifting off my shoulders, and I feel great now.
Was it harder than you thought, this whole process?
Yeah. Everyone dreams of going to the NBA, but there's a lot of things that go that play into that. And it's like a dream at first, but you gotta get to the business part of the aspect of it. And he's done, Coach Mack has done a great job of like helping me with that. But it's just been, everything's been hard, like the logistics part. But I've been trying to like have fun with it, and I've had fun with it. So it's been pretty cool so far.
Justin, did what was there a point in the last 3 weeks where it really did crystallize in your, maybe it was over the last couple of days, where it really you settled into that decision of, okay, yeah, I'm ready to pull the trigger? And why did you come to that decision, that moment?
Yeah, like it was about, like Coach Mack said, it was about 4 days ago, 5 days ago, where I was just like all in for it because I knew what I wanted to do. And usually in life, you go through these things and you never know what's going to be the outcome. You just go at it and you just try to attack it. And that's what I'm going to do. I don't know what the outcome's going to be. I don't know if I'm going to be a legend or I'm going to be a bust, but I'm going to work my hardest to be the best. So I'm not going in with any promises or anything. I'm just going to try my hardest and work hard. And I'm sold on going, and I'm happy, and I'm going to work my hardest to be where I want to be.
And anything about this process surprise you or kind of catch you off guard a little bit over the last 2 or 3 months?
The whole process itself has surprised me, yeah. Like I said, a year ago, I didn't think, or 2 years ago, I didn't think I'd be in this spot, you know, choosing Creighton, and now I'm going to be on an NBA platform making a decision, making this big decision. So it's all been a surprise. It's been a whirlwind, and I've had to learn a lot fast.
This is for Mac. He had a redshirt season a year ago. You said he wasn't ready. What kind of coaching job and what did you do to make him into a – first round pick in just a year?
Well, he did a lot of it. Obviously there was a plan in place. Coach Bailey and the strength staff did a tremendous job at helping Justin understand the importance of strength training. And along with that, at the same time, although I'm still not certain his eating habits are great, they got a lot better. And he was able to put on weight and maintain that weight. And his conditioning got better. Coach DeVries in particular, but all of our staff work with him outside of practice time, developing his skill set. And, you know, Justin likes to be in the gym. You know, he enjoys being in the gym. He enjoys the game of basketball. He's blessed with a unique IQ for the game for someone as young as he is. And when it all clicked on the floor this year, it came like gangbusters. I mean, his improvement from last February, March till November was really incredible, but his improvement from November to January was also incredible, and you usually don't see that with a young player. But he, you know, Justin put the time in. He's earned the opportunity and the right to do this.
Justin, this might be tough to summarize in this setting, but I mean, you go back 3 years, and I think when you committed, when it was announced that you committed, no one really knew who you were. I think you were working at the concession stand at the College World Series at the time. And now 3 years, fast forward 3 years, you're sitting here in this room declaring for the NBA draft. I mean, does it feel like a whirlwind? Does it feel like what you envisioned? Or is all of this just, I mean, how are you soaking all this in considering the journey you've been on and how fast it's gone?
I feel like, I don't know. I feel like when I chose Creighton, I opened the door and I'm just walking down this hallway and a lot of doors are open. And it's not just like the NBA, it's like the people that I've met. And I've met so many great people in this trial that I've had here at Creighton. And it's been crazy how many people I've met and how many people have had a huge impact on my decision and in my life in general. So it's been crazy to think about. And I haven't really brought it all in. Maybe when I sit back and I'm old and I got kids and I can't move anymore, I'll think about it. But I don't really have time to think now.
Justin, everything has moved so fast for you in such a short period of time. When did you first believe that you really had a chance at the NBA? I mean, when did those thoughts first seriously enter your mind? And was it people talking to you about that? And who were those people? And when did you really believe it yourself?
I would have to say this really, it was after the first actual home game, regular season. It was after the game, and I played all right. I didn't think I played good. And me and Maurice and Marcus were talking, and he was just like, "Yeah, bro, you good. You're good." And I'm like, "Well, I guess." And then, so after the season played on, then all my teammates were like gassing me up and like putting my head up and telling me how good I was. I just was always modest about it. But then, as the season was coming to an end, and around January, I was like, "This could be a just could be big for me. And I was looking at all the other freshmen around the conference and just people who are thinking about entering the draft, and I'm comparing myself to them. I'm like, why not me? So I just thought I can do it.
And Coach Mack, if I may, when did you first see that potential in him, and when did you believe it?
We saw some potential last year during practice, but it was sporadic. He would have a great day, and then he'd have 6 days in a row where Jeff Grozel would kick his tail, and then he'd have another great day. But you could see it, and you could see it coming as he got stronger and he got in better shape. But, you know, this year, you know, November and December, and I think back to the Wisconsin game in particular, you know, those are grown men he was playing against. And, you know, some of those transition opportunities was like he was shot out of a cannon. And I think at that point I knew that he had a chance to be special. Did I think it would happen this fast? Probably not. But he kept working and he got better, and it's been fun to be part of, to sit back and watch it really develop in front of our eyes, because he grew up in front of our eyes this season in large part.
Justin, just talk about this journey from growing up in Omaha, playing at Omaha North, and how big a dream was this from you from the start to make it to the NBA draft?
It's always been a dream. I've been playing basketball for a really long time. And as a kid, you always dream about going to NBA or NFL or something like that. And it's an honor to be right here today. But as a kid, you never really think about in depth about going that far. It's just like a dream. So it's crazy to think about. And I want all the kids like out there to know that like it's possible for anybody. I never think I would be on this platform talking to you guys in front of all these people, cameras and stuff. I was just at Omaha North in class, like in PE class, goofing around, and now I'm here on a NBA like level. I'm going to be at the NBA level and doing things that I never thought I could be doing. Everyone starts somewhere, and I started somewhere. Omaha is a really great place, and so many people have had ingredients in me and like put their time in me and made me the person I am today. And I can't say thank you enough to everyone in Omaha and Creighton and the Creighton staff and my coaching staff, the faculty, everyone. I've had so many people just come in my life and bless me and put me on the right path and make sure I stayed the course, and that's how I got here today. So it all goes credit to Omaha, credit to Creighton, and of course credit to me, but without them I would really be nothing.
Justin, the draft's in two months, right? Mm-hmm. What do you want to show between now and then? What can you show during these next few weeks?
I just want to show my game. I'm not going to come out and like be a player I'm not. I got to the point where I am because I played my game and I did what I do. Now I am going to make some improvements on wherever I got to make improvements at, but they're not buying Justin Patton, whoever he was going to be. They're buying Justin Patton, who's what they saw this year and probably a little bit more. But so I'm not going to come out and do anything crazy. I'm just going to train super hard and work hard at everything I don't got and work hard at the things I do have. So I'll just altogether just make a huge like focus on myself and just becoming a better player and getting in shape to do it, because that's the biggest thing, is being in that shape.
Any further questions?
I got one for you, Coach. Just we saw it from our vantage point, just the hype around Justin grew. I mean, he went from Wisconsin. As the season went on, it sort of built on itself. How did you notice he handled it, and what did you try to, like, was there a moment when you just said, wow, this might overwhelm him, or we really got to kind of,
you know, I think Justin's done a good job of surrounding himself with a good support system. You know, his family's been terrific in helping him, and I think his teammates did a great job of keeping him in check and helping him through the tough days. Obviously it weighs on your shoulders when you know, he's a 19-year-old kid and he's going to read some of the draft stuff and you see your name, and that's cool. That's awesome. That's what he's worked for his whole life. And I think you feel a little bit more added pressure to perform at a certain level. And our message to him was they've made their decision. I mean, they've seen you play. They understand your skill set. They understand your potential. Just go out and have fun and enjoy it. So that if this is your last time through it, that you can look back at it as something that was very enjoyable. And I think Justin did that. And obviously getting to the finals of the Big East tournament, something that, you know, standing on that stage is really cool for him. I'm glad he got an opportunity to play in an NCAA tournament, because there's a lot of players never get that chance. So, you know, while he was only here a short time, you know, he had a huge impact on our program.
Hey, Coach, obviously
mixed emotions for you, happy for Justin, sad to see him leave, but how can you, moving forward, you know, use this to your advantage, the story of what Justin's been able to do at Creighton and getting to the NBA as quickly as he did?
Well, I don't have mixed emotions. I'm 100%, and Justin knew this at the onset, that whatever he decided to do, I'm on board 100%. And if you were to ask him and back him in a corner, he'd probably tell you that I probably encouraged him to take a serious look at this, given where he's at and you know where the NBA is going and the risk of injury and everything that goes with that. So I'm 100% excited and enthused for him. But you know, it's anytime you have guys that go on to play in the NBA and then represent themselves in the right way, it's a huge plus for our program. And you know, we're blessed right now to have Anthony and Kyle and Doug that are doing a good job in their respective careers, but also doing a good job in their communities where they're playing. And when they come back to Omaha, they still have a huge impact in Omaha. And I think Justin is going to be the same. You know, he understands the importance of treating people the right way and giving back to your community. And he understands the value of hard work and what it's going to take for him to be successful at the next level. So it's great for us. Obviously, you know, we had a plan for Justin. We pitched it to him coming out of high school. We had to pitch it again to convince him that redshirting was the best idea. And it turned out great. And does every plan work out perfectly? No. But I think everybody was on board with this. His family was. Justin was. Our staff did a terrific job of getting him to this point. But again, without Justin and his efforts and his buy-in, none of this happens. I mean, he's got to be willing to do the work. And he's moving on to a stage of his career that's going to require more work. And, you know, he likes to have fun, and he's going to enjoy this. But he also understands he's got a busy 2 months ahead in preparation for the draft.
Hey, Mac, having gone through this just a few years ago with Doug, how did that help you, and how were the situations maybe different?
You know, I think obviously having gone through the whole agent thing and those meetings and everything that goes with that, I mean, Justin's eyes the first meeting, I thought, I looked over at him, he's like, you could tell his head was spinning because it's just information overload. So, you know, that experience certainly helped me help him to kind of understand what to expect, what questions to ask, what to look for, what you need that's different than what Doug needed. And Justin was able to reach out to Doug, which, you know, not often you have a guy in the NBA that you know at a personal level that, you know, ask him any question, Justin, he'll answer it for you. And hopefully that helped Justin provide a little bit of clarity for himself as well. But it, you know, it was a quick process because we finished and we started the meetings really that next weekend. And, you know, his family was great. You know, they were involved and engaged and asked the right questions and I think helped him make the decision that I think in the long term is going to be best for him.
Hey, Justin, besides your close friends and family, who did you lean on to reach out? Max said you reached out to Doug, and what did he tell you? Maybe perhaps a couple other influential outsiders that maybe not here close to home that helped you make the decision?
Dave Sokol, he helped me a lot in this process. He's like I said, he's a very successful person, and he just looks at everything the right way. And he tries to talk to me from a standpoint where it's not about basketball, it's not about any of the hype or anything. It's about me and him. And he was telling me like, there's no biases or anything when he's telling me. And he helped me a lot. I can lean on him. I can talk to him about the business, I can talk to him about life, or I can just talk to him about my school or whatever. So he helped me a lot, and it was obviously a lot of people, but my family is really where I leaned on a lot, and Coach Mack and my coaching staff, Coach DeVries. I needed people to lean on. They were there for me, so I'm just happy that I can say that I have a support system like them. So
we'll take two more questions starting
from us. Justin, let's just cut to the chase. Who would you like to play for? Who would you like to have draft you?
It doesn't really matter who I play for. Whoever I play for, I'll play hard. And I'll do my job, but it's always been a dream to play in the NBA. I never decided what team I wanted to play for. It was just I wanted to play in the NBA. So if I play for whatever team, I'm just going to play my hardest and have fun.
Any further last questions? Coach, Justin, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, everyone, for coming.
Thank you.